हेलो एवरीवन, माय सेल्फ मिस शैलजा देवरकोंडा, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन सिविल इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट, वालचंद इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी, सोलापुर. इन टुडेज लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी काइनेमैटिक्स ऑफ पार्टिकल लर्निंग आउटकम्स. एट द एंड ऑफ दिस सेशन द स्टूडेंट्स विल एबल टू कैलकुलेट द वेलोसिटी एंड डायरेक्शन ऑफ द प्रोजेक्टाइल फॉर डिफरेंट लेवल्स. डिफरेंट लेवल्स मीन्स द स्टार्टिंग पॉइंट ऑफ द प्रोजेक्टाइल एंड द स्ट्राइक point of the projectile is at different height. When the particle is projected on level ground surface, it will strike on the same level. The point of projection and point of strike is different in this case. If you consider any particle and if you are throwing it upward, normally we will observe it is going vertical, but it will have the two directions, that is vertical as well as horizontal direction. So we will consider it as the inclined projection. Okay, so in this lecture we are going to study the point of projection and the point of strike at the different level. Now let us consider the point of projection is at height of y0 above the point of strike as shown in figure number 1. So here you can observe this figure. Here the particle is thrown, or the projection of the particle is inclined with the initial velocity u. After reaching a certain point, the velocity of particle will be 0, and again it will coming downwards to the earth due to the gravitational force. Okay, so here you can observe the starting point of the particle or the projectile and the strike point of the projectile are at different level. Normally this case is observed in the sloping grounds and all. Okay, so the difference between the point A and B is shown or is notified by the y0. So it is the height between the starting point and the strike point of the particle. This point C is the maximum height which is reached by the particle. Okay, on already we have seen the projection of projectile on the leveled ground surface. Leveled ground surface means the starting point and the strike point is at the same level. In that case, the horizontal range is calculated by u into t, means it is initial velocity into time required to reach from point A to point B, and the maximum height is given by 1/2 g t square. G is the gravitational force and T is the time required to this maximum, to reach the maximum height. Okay, so in this case we will find the velocity where the point of application and the point of strike will be different. Okay, so by considering the vertical direction of the projectile for a same ground level, inclined projectile for a same ground level, the y is equal to u sin alpha into t minus 1/2 gt square. Okay, so it is the horizontal component of the projectile. Okay, from the equation of vertical direction of the inclined projectile, you will get y is equal to u sin alpha into t minus 1/2 gt square. This u sin alpha t is the vertical component of the inclined projectile. Here the strike point is below the point of application. So we will consider is here y is equal to minus y0, because it is below the starting point, or you can say it is below the original level. Okay, so The time required to reach at station B is given by minus y0 is equal to u sine alpha into t minus 1 half g t square, which is okay. And the horizontal range is given by r is equal to u cos alpha t into, and the horizontal range is given by u cos alpha into t. This u cos alpha is the horizontal component of the inclined projectile. Okay, so here they have mentioned the height, and you have to calculate the time required to reach the next point. Here they have mentioned the height, and you have to find out the time required to reach the end station. Now we will see the problem, how to calculate the time of flight, range and maximum height. Okay, in this problem, a bullet is fired from a height of 120 meter at a velocity of 360 km per hour at an angle of 30 degree upwards, means it is inclined projection throwing upwards with the inclination of 30 degree. Okay, so neglecting the air resistance, find the total time of flight, horizontal range of bullet, maximum height reached by the bullet, and final velocity of the bullet just before touching the ground. Now we will see further how to calculate these things. Okay, the initial velocity is given as 360 km per hour. So if you convert it, it will be 100 meter per second. The angle of projection is also given in problem, that is 30 degree. Okay, so this initial velocity is in kilometer per hour. So first you have to convert it into meter per second. So it is, initial velocity is 100 meter per second. Then total time of flight, we have the equation, that is by considering the vertical motion, y is equal to vertical component of the projectile, that is u sine alpha into t 1 half g t square. So here the height is given as 120 meter, means the strike point is given as 120 meter. So it is below the point of application, so we have considered it as a negative. Initial velocity u is 100, and gravitational force is taken as 9.81. so putting these all values in this equation, y is equal to u sine alpha t minus 1 of gt square, you will get the time required to reach from point A to point B. So to reach the particle from point A to B is 12.20 seconds. Then you have to calculate the maximum height reached by the bullet. The maximum height is calculated by u sine square alpha square. Next, you have to find out the maximum height reached by the bullet. Maximum height means this bullet is reached at this point C, means it is the maximum height where it will go with its initial velocity, and at this stage, at this point C, its velocity will be zero, and again it will start flowing down. Okay, so this maximum height is calculated by h is equal to u square sine square alpha by 2g. So these all equations are derived from the inclined projection on the leveled ground. Okay, so initial velocity is 100. By putting the value of initial velocity and gravitational force, you will get the height, maximum height, that is 127.42 meters. Okay, so this 127.42 meters is from the point A. Okay, but your bullet is strike below the 120 meter from the point A. So it should, the maximum height should be calculated from the point B. So here the total height should be 127.42 plus 120, which is 247.42 meter from the ground where the bullet is reached or where the bullet is striked. Okay, now we have to calculate the horizontal range. Horizontal range means it is the distance between horizontal distance between the two points, means start points and end point. Due to inclined projection, we have to consider the inclined component of the projectile. Okay, so it r is equal to for the vertical projectile, we will consider u into t, that is initial velocity into time. Here it is inclined, so we are considering horizontal component of this inclined projection. Now you have to calculate the horizontal range. Range is nothing but the distance between two points, that is start point and end point. Here this is the inclined projection of the bullet, so you have to consider the horizontal component of the bullet. So it is u cos alpha t, alpha into t. So t already we have calculated, that is 12.20 seconds, and initial velocity is also known as, that is 100 meter per second. So horizontal distance between point A and B is 1056.55 meter, and the total height is 247.42 meter from the point B. Now we have to find out the final velocity just before striking the ground. Here it has, the bullet is projected inclined, so it has vertical component as well as initial component. So first you have to calculate its vertical component and initial component. So here the vertical component of the velocity is u sin alpha minus g into t. So the vertical component of the velocity is 69.628 meter. It is negative, means it is representing as it is acting downward, because we have to calculate the velocity just before to strike the ground. So it is gravitational force is acting downward, so we have considered here it as a negative. So this velocity is acting downward. Then horizontal component, that is u cos alpha, so you will get the horizontal component of velocity is 86.603 meter per second. Then the final velocity will be nothing but the resultant of these two forces. So the resultant is calculated as some fx under root of fx square plus fy square. So the same formula is applied here, and we have calculated the final velocity. Okay, see, this is the inclined projection, so we have calculated the horizontal and vertical component, and from component of velocity, and from that we have calculated the original velocity of the bullet. So this bullet is strike to the ground with an velocity of 111.16 meter per second at an inclination of 38.82 degrees. So likewise, we have to apply the equations to the given problem, and you have to find out the unknowns, that is time of flight, maximum height, horizontal range, or either velocity. Now you pause this video and try to answer this question. These are the answer. These are the references considered for the study. Thank you.